Bust down, that's what's on my fucking wrist, nigga. Overseas, I put that shit on my bitch, nigga. Big blood kush while I'm counting through a check. All school snatching like a brand new bitch. I'm just gonna tell y'all the truth, man. I can't respect nothing like, I just, the music cool, the money cool, all that. Just, but if I don't respect you, if it's something about you I just don't respect, bro, I can't sit and fake and act like it's all good.
Everybody really can do it, but it's about who really wanna do it, who really want it. Everybody gonna run their mouth about, man, I'm gonna do this. Next time you see them, what they doing, you still talking. Then you got some other people like, man, they just sit and they just watch everybody doing everything. Like, man, he doing this, he got this. They can tell you everything was going on about everything. Feel what I'm saying?
Definitely.
It really ain't numbers, staying focused, bro. That's all it is, bro.
You said you used to serve his big brother bricks.
Hell nah. I ain't say that.
Yeah, you did.
I ain't never said nothing about no bricks my whole career, Charlamagne. You tripping.
Where you getting
tripping?
What was the lyric?
You tripping. You can go back. We can bet some money.
Don't play
if
with
I said something about some bricks, I'd give you a $1 million check right now.
Big brother.
Oh, you used to front your big brother. That's what you said. You ain't say bricks. You just said front you.
Still that same nigga that used to front your big brother. Facts. Found out he a bitch too, now I call him your big sister, bitch.
I didn't know a big brother. I helped put, you know what I'm saying? I helped, you know what I mean? It was right. A bun, you know what I mean? Back in the day, I helped out.
Right. So you know that in the family, yeah.
Man.
Up in the 100 drops. My role model used to get 100 blocks. Hey. Street niggas in a tuxedo, we the mob. She looked at my watch too long, now she see stars. I got so high last night, I did a show on Mars. Yo, bitch ate my dick, I caught her on them bars. My pinky ring, extra large. Phones all in the garage. Remember my first Menard? Yeah, Toy and Britney. I'm shopping for diamonds and Tiffany's. Nah, I don't got no sympathy. Nah. She blew my whistle like a referee. What? Broke black nigga, remember me? Hey. Until I found out that recipe. Started getting about 10 a week. Yeah. Finger on the trigger when I sleep. Yo. Yeah, nigga, I'd rather you than me. Yo. Backseat smoking good weed. Gelato. 100 shots. How the fuck you miss a whole 100 shots?
Young Dolph. Born Adolph Thornton Jr. on July 27th, 1985 in Chicago, Illinois, Dolph's life is a testament to hustle, resilience, and pure talent. Dolph moved to Memphis, Tennessee at a young age. He quickly adapted to the Southern culture, which later became a significant influence on his music. Growing up in the rough neighborhoods of South Memphis, Dolph faced numerous challenges, but instead of letting his environment define him, he used it as fuel to ignite his rap career. In 2008, Dolph released his first mixtape, Paper Route Campaign. This marked the beginning of his journey in the rap industry. His raw lyrics and unique flow caught the attention of rap fans and industry insiders alike. Dolph wasn't just another rapper, he had a story to tell, and he did it with authenticity. Young Dolph's grind was relentless. He founded his own label, Paper Route Empire, setting the stage for independent success. Unlike many artists who sign with major labels, Dolph believed in maintaining control over his music. This decision allowed him to stay true to his roots and deliver music that resonated with his fans. In 2016, Dolph dropped his debut studio album, King of Memphis. The album solidified his place in the rap scene, showcasing his lyrical prowess and street credibility. Tracks like Get Paid became anthems for anyone hustling to make a better life. Dolph's music was more than just beats and rhymes. It was a reflection of his life's struggles and triumphs. But with success came challenges. Dolph faced multiple life-threatening situations, including two shooting incidents in 2017. Despite these attempts on his life, he remained undeterred. In fact, these experiences only seemed to strengthen his resolve and deepen his connection with his fans. One of Dolph's most notable traits was his commitment to giving back to his community. He frequently returned to Memphis to support local initiatives and uplift the next generation. Dolph understood the importance of using his platform to make a positive impact. Tragically, young Dolph's life was cut short on November 17th, 2021, when he was fatally shot in Memphis. His death sent shockwaves through the rap community and left a void that can never be filled. But while Dolph may be gone, his legacy lives on through his music and the countless lives he touched. Young Dolph's journey is a powerful reminder of what it means to stay true to oneself. He rose from the streets of Memphis to become an icon, all while staying independent and authentic. His story is one of perseverance, resilience, and unwavering dedication. Rest in peace, Young Dolph. Your music and your spirit will continue to inspire us all. Thanks for tuning in, folks. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe for more deep dives into the lives of your favorite rappers. Until next time.
Yeah.
Go get the money.
Oh! Royalty. Yeah, royalty, royalty, royalty. Ain't number made men and women. Treat all of my niggas like royalty. My brothers. And all of my bitches, they loyal to me. Yeah. Hey, hey, yeah. Royalty kings. Royalty, yeah. Royalty, royalty, royalty. Hey, hey. Treat all of my niggas like royalty. Woo. And all of my bitches, they loyal to me.
I love them.
It's Dolph.
My little bitch. A worldwide tour. Look who he riding in.
I just spent the 100 with you. Fuck about none of this shit, yeah. Yeah. I just pulled up at the car lot, spent a half a mil like fuck it. Thought he was a real one, but he wasn't, so it's fuck him. I just pulled a 6 in a 1 liter, I'm like fuck it. If I let your bitch come get me head, then that bitch lucky.
What you doing?
I'm drinking dirty, I'm riding dirty. She got on no panties, but I'm in the Harry. Permit to see with codeine when I get thirsty. I told all my niggas I got them, don't worry. I fucked up 200,000 on jewelry.
Young Dolph is home.
I ain't been home in a minute, too, bro.
Young Dolph! Woo! Young Dolph!
Memphis, make some motherfucking noise!
Good evening, I'm Rick Garcia.
And I'm Pat Harvey. Breaking news, a shooting at a popular tourist spot in Hollywood. Tonight, a rapper is in critical condition.
It happened just after 1 this afternoon in front of the Lowe's Hotel at the Hollywood and Highland Complex.
And CBS 2's Dave Lopez is live in Hollywood with more information. Dave.
Right in front of where that shooting took place, we can tell you the rapper's real name is Adolph Thornton. He comes out of Memphis. He's been a big star on the rap scene since 2014. He goes by the name of Young Dolph is his rapper name. He is in critical condition, according to the LAPD, but not life-threatening injuries. He apparently is either still in surgery or about to get out of surgery after being shot numerous times in the upper body right across the street. And they say it could be back to, it could go connected to a feud that rap groups are having, the feud that goes all the way back to February.
Adolph Robert Thornton Jr., known as Young Dolph, rose to fame mixing tapes and was soon hitting the national music charts.
His death attracted a large crowd to the cookie store on Airways Boulevard, many frustrated and angry that this could happen here. Tonight, we have Team 3 coverage of that shooting, the investigation, and the impact he had on music and the community.
WREG's Melissa Moon begins our Team 3 coverage live from the crime scene on Airways, where police are still searching for evidence. Melissa?
Well, police have finally cleared this scene, but there are family members and fans here tonight. And as you can see behind me, they have boarded up the windows of this business that were damaged or shattered by gunfire. Police are asking for calm as they investigate this murder.
The family of Young Dolph says a public memorial is being planned for the slain rapper, but details are still being finalized. In the meantime, we are getting an exclusive look inside the private funeral for Young Dolph that was held on Tuesday. Among the celebrities attending, artists, 2 Chainz, and Monica. Several friends and family members spoke at the service, including Young Dolph's children.
Listening to them say, "I love my dad," you know, and it was the way they said it. It was powerful. They miss him. Mm-hmm. They really miss him. So that broke my heart, you know, to see those children, little boy and girl, crying for their father.